We saw the floods of 2008 impact so much of eastern Iowa. Then we saw subsequent floods in 2011 on the Missouri River, and quite frankly, we've had floods, if not every year, every couple of years in Iowa that have had a major impact to the state. Everything within the program is driven locally by local communities, local counties, local business owners, local landowners.
Groups like the Watershed Management Authorities are the first time that people have sat down across the table from one another and looked across the table to somebody that's not in their political boundary and said, what you're doing upstream in your county or city impacts us. I think watershed management authorities are the perfect method to move things along in terms of flood mitigation and water quality.
We had been talking about how can we afford to redo this pond. We didn't want to just give it up. And then this watershed project came up to help, you know, control some flooding right here in Johnson County in Corville and Iowa City. And I mean, it was like a win-win. There was just no downside to this.
It's really been a pleasure for us to see how landowners now better understand how their land is part of a landscape and river system that's all tied together and impacts so many people downstream from them.
I guess there's a little pride involved that I took care of this land. Okay, that's number one for me. I took care of it, I just didn't leave a nasty ditch running down through here. I've got a feature that's nice to look at. And here's the deal, people don't understand a pond because look, it's full, it's running out of the tube. But it still has capacity above that tube. So when that tube reaches maximum capacity, you start building this up. That's a savings. Otherwise, it goes down there 100 miles an hour and hits the river. And then all of a sudden, all the rivers are up. And so the cost benefit to me is less damage downstream. There's less siltation, because if there is dirty water coming in here, it's going to slow it down. And as soon as dirty water slows down, it drops the silt. And you want to just slow everything down as fast as you can.
You know, if we can stop that up there, slow that down up there, and have it infiltrate around the northern areas, not as much water gets to us.
Well, the university, of course, one of our major impacts in a program like this is, you know, scientific discovery as well as technology development. And, you know, at the University of Iowa, we work on both.
What the Flood Center has been able to do with their modeling, essentially, is to say we can put a number to it. So if you put in this detention structure, that may capture up to 40% of a 5.5-inch rainfall that's coming down your gully. Now we have a number, a very tangible, real result that's backed up through their modeling. And that just validates what we're trying to do. You know, I think that that's super helpful.
The Iowa Watershed Approach really provides the template. We have developed a template that works in Iowa. Today we see that watershed management authorities continue to develop all across our state. That's an exciting opportunity for people to become involved.
Now we're doing a lot better job of farming. We're saving this soil for my grandkids.
You know, let's look down the road. Let's look at the what you're leaving for the next generation, and we can do better here.